Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Holy Redeemer, Our Lady Perpetual Help in St. Michael Catholic Churches, as we gather this day to celebrate the 22nd Sunday in Ordinary Time. We are happy that you are with us today and invite you to take part in the liturgy as best you can, certainly using the liturgical aid that has been downloaded or uploaded or whatever you want to call it to our Facebook pages, as well as our parish websites and my own personal webpage. Today's Mass, we want to pray especially for our brothers and sisters who are being impacted by Hurricane Ida on the Gulf Coast. We know a lot of our parishioners are here at Holy Redeemer are from Louisiana and have relatives there, and many of our parishioners who have moved back to Louisiana since Hurricane Katrina are there, and we are lifting you all up in prayer. And we pray especially for our men and women in harm's way in Afghanistan. We pray for them, and we pray for our Afghan allies who are in great peril at this time, trying to escape the country. And so we pray for all of them at this time also. I invite you to turn to page 2 of our worship aid and join me praying the Vincentian prayer for an end to the coronavirus pandemic. Gracious God, protector of the defenseless, look with compassion to people who are suffering from the dangers of this global pandemic. Be compassionate to us, infinite mercy, and guide the hands of those who are attempting to overcome this situation. Instill within us a spirit of generosity, that we might know how to assist those who are the weakest, the elderly, the homeless, and the impoverished, those who bear the brunt of this crisis. Let us approach these individuals and assist them in these difficult times, protecting doctors, nurses, and all healthcare professionals who are on the front line of this pandemic. Enlighten their minds so that they might find a cure. We ask all of this through the intercession of Jesus Christ, your Son and our Lord, the protector of those in need. Amen. Together we implore the protection of the Blessed Mother as we pray. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Our Lady of the Miraculous Medal, pray for us. Good morning and welcome.
Good morning.
Thank you.
Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Praise to our Lord Jesus Christ, in the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Sisters and brothers, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess,
Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus Christ, your Son,
who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
Let us be seated as we listen to the word of the Lord.
Have you ever been taking a shower
And you live in one of those houses that the plumbing is a little bit peculiar. And it's nice and warm and you're doing your little thing and all of a sudden the toilet's flush. And you get a glass of cold water. And it wakes you up. Well, that's what this gospel can kind of be compared to today. Like they were describing the Pharisees were taking a warm shower. And Jesus came along and flushed the toilet. And all of a sudden, he woke them up. You know, but as I hear this, I couldn't help thinking today would probably say about sanitizing your hands as opposed to washing them with sanitizer. So as we get this, I wanted to know, I never thought about that. I just figured washing your hands, purifying your hands. That's what I thought. Well, listen to this, because you're going to understand a little bit more what they had to go through in order to purify. You know, the scribes and the elders, they saw it not simply as a matter of good personal hygiene, but it was also a means of attaining ceremonial or ritual cleanliness, i.e. holiness. Before every meal and between each course, hands were washed according to a specific procedure. First, the hands were held with fingertips pointing upwards, and the ceremonial pure water that was poured over them had to run down to the wrist. The amount of water that was used had to be enough to fill 1.5 eggshells. Then each hand had to be cleansed with the fist of the other. At this point, however, the water was rendered unclean. Therefore, fresh water, again of a specified amount, had to be poured over the hands, the fingertips of which were now pointing downward. This being done, the hands were clean, and the person to whom they belonged was regarded as clean or holy. And of course, they were similarly detailed specifics about washing cups, jugs, and kettles. So the scribes were questioning Jesus, why don't your followers do that? Well, needless to say, what Jesus is going to say and what he assumes to say, it's about faith. It's not about these man-made rules that you have put in place. You have put these rules in place. It is not the law of Moses, as we heard in the first reading. God gave the law to Moses. And what the scribes and the Pharisees did was they put a wall around the laws, essentially, that kept people from attaining it. And then they did their own interpretation. The righteous, they were righteous. So they did these interpretations. Well, who in their right mind would be able to do this? So it separated the pure from the unpure. You get what was happening? And what Jesus is saying, this is not what it's about. It is about faith. It is about following the law of God. Quit putting these things into place that keep people from ultimately following the law and being close to God. So he turns everything upside down. He's slapping them in the face. He's saying, this is not the way it is to be. And we have to recognize that in our own lives. In our own lives, I think we need to recognize that we are called to be people of faith. And some of the things that get in the way quite often are man-made things that get in the way. Let me give just a few examples.
For me?
Yeah, for you. Now look, our wonderful Christian here with this wonderful suit. It's not studying. Then look at Anthony. With a simple polo shirt and blue jeans, black jeans.
should come to church. This is how you should not come to church. He is mean and ugly and came in here thinking, I can't believe she came to church today. Well, look at him. He's only wearing blue jeans. And boy, did I treat that poor person with great disrespect. Look at everyone. I'm happy that they're here to worship the Lord today. I'm glad I was able to help the poor this week. I'm about love and peace and joy. My heart is open to how the Lord wants to change me. Okay, you get my point? It's not the outside that the Lord is worried about. It's the inside that the Lord is worried about. Thank you, God. Yes, I'm so grateful that I knew they could take it. I made any comments about their wardrobe. I called up any of the ladies today. I've been crucified. But the thing is, brothers and sisters, it's how we come into this place. It's how we come into this place that makes a difference. A heart open to change. Sunday morning is not a masquerade party. Okay? Don't come into church masquerading who you are. Because you are God's child, pure and holy. But sometimes we've got a lot of stuff weighing us down. Anger, resentment, fear. Bring it in here. Give it to him. Let him deal with it. You think he can? He can. But don't come in here pretending that you are something that you are not. This is where God calls you to be as his child, chosen and revered. But we come as imperfect creatures. We come as imperfect creatures in need of forgiveness and mercy and love. So if you think all that makeup, all that perfume, all that jewelry, all those fancy clothes are going to change that, brothers and sisters, you're going to walk out feeling the same way you came walking in. Amen. It's when we can be truly honest with the Lord and open with the Lord and open our hearts to change that things can happen. Amen. We bring that weakness, that brokenness, that sinfulness to the Lord, and we let the Lord do what the Lord wants to do with it. He will transform it. He will transform our sadness to joy. He will transform the weaknesses to strength. He will transform the brokenness to wholeness. But you got to be open to it. If you ain't open to it, it ain't going to happen. Amen. It ain't going to happen. So put on all the clothes you want, all the fancy things you want. But brothers and sisters, if your heart is not open, it doesn't make any difference. It doesn't make any difference. The color of the clothing on the outside doesn't. Here's a good example. Just because you wear pink and green don't make you a good AKA. Just because you wear red don't make you a good duck. Just because you wear purple and gold don't make you a good Omega. Just because you wear black and gold don't make you a good Alpha. And just because you wear black and red don't make you a good cat. It's what's inside. That's what the Lord is calling us to today. He's calling us to pay attention to what is in here. Yes, it's important. Yeah, and it was important as a good Jew to wash your hands from the standpoint of hygiene and also to purify. But when those things become obstacles to following the law, there's a problem. And when we, in our congregations, put up things that are obstacles to people coming to the Lord, that is a problem. That is a problem. So it doesn't matter what color blue you wear for sodality. What matters is that you love the Lord. That you love the Lord. It doesn't matter whether you're wearing those kind of shoes that lace up, or sandals, or slip-ons, or whatever, it doesn't matter. What matters is that your heart's open to being changed, converted, and made whole in Jesus Christ. Amen.
Sunday morning, brothers and sisters, isn't a masquerade party. It's for us to come truly and authentically as we are. God's chosen ones. God's holy ones. Open to receiving His love, His mercy, His forgiveness, and His fullness, and to be transformed more and more into His image and likeness. Amen. Today, I'd like to bless over the Brooklyn.
Next week. Next week. I don't have it.
Oh, next week's the blessing.
Yeah.
I thought it was this week. Let us stand and make our profession. I believe in one God, the Father of the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things are made. For us and then for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and came in. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is glorified and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
My sisters and brothers, we honor God with a heart that generates love. With love for all people, let us offer our prayers to God.
For the church, that we may experience an ever deeper conversion of mind and heart as we allow God's word to instruct and free us, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For peace, that the Spirit will renew the dedication of those working for peace, and help all to work together to defeat the common enemies of disease, ignorance, and poverty. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who are suffering from natural disasters, and for those assisting them, that God will calm the wildfires, help people of Haiti to recover, and sustain all who are helping them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For wisdom, that God will teach us how to live the virtues of the Christian life and manifest them in new ways in our contemporary society. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who are sick, especially those suffering from the coronavirus, that God will curtail the surge in the COVID virus, send healing to all who are ill, and give strength. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all who have died, especially those who honored God in this life with generous and loving hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the prayers that were submitted online throughout the week, for the prayers written in the Book of Intentions and offered in the live stream online, and for the prayers we now make in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And let us remember today brothers and sisters in harm's way in Louisiana, that people might be kept safe through the hurricane. We also pray for those men and women, our servicemen and women who were killed in Afghanistan. We pray for those men and women who are still serving in Afghanistan in harm's way, and for those Afghan civilians who are our allies, for their safety as we continue to seek to help them to be moved out of Afghanistan. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Merciful Father, your Son teaches us to look deep within to discover that which is the root of all sin. Give us hearts that desire serious introspection so that we may know all that comes from within might be fitting for your honor and glory. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and giving thanks broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, the supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more, giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of
thank you. I ask you to come spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as you are.
Please, Father, let your blessings be upon me.
Let us pray. Renewed by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you, Lord, that being the food of charity, it may confirm our hearts and stir us to serve you and our neighbor, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now, I pay attention to what is put in my binder, and I knew that there was supposed to be a blessing for school children in my binder, and it was not in my binder. But I'm going to give a blessing for school children and teachers today, because Lord knows we need it.
Amen.
We need it. And it can't wait another week, right? So I'm going to give students and our teachers a blessing this morning as they begin their school year, not only for the smarts up here and for the wisdom they're giving to the kids, but also for safety in the classrooms, for God's sake, for the coronavirus and all the ill. So let's give them a blessing.
Amen.
Let us bow our heads and pray for God's blessing. Lord our God, in your wisdom and love, you surround us with the mysteries of the universe. In times long past, you sent us your prophets to teach your laws and to bear witness to your undying love. You sent your Son to teach us by word and example that true wisdom comes from you alone. Send your Spirit upon all our students and their teachers, and fill them with your wisdom and blessing. Grant that during this academic year, they may devote themselves to their studies and share what they have learned from others. And loving God, we ask you to keep all of our students, teachers, administrators, and staff safe from the coronavirus, that they may protect their children and all those in the classroom from this disease. Loving God, we ask you to fill your hearts of all your teachers with love for your children, for the children that they are called to serve, and may our children be open to wisdom and learning. And may Almighty God bless all of them, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth glorifying the Lord by your lives. Announcements will follow the closing song. For joining us. What a wonderful celebration today. Great to have so many people here. Are there any guests and visitors here for the first time today? Any guests or visitors here for the first time? Stand up, take your mask off, tell us who you are and where you are from.
the Evergene. Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Church,
that you take a picture of your screen with me on it doing Mass, and you text it to the teacher so that we know that you are at least watching the liturgy on Sunday. I'm just saying. Looking at volunteers to help keep our churches clean, if you are interested, please let us know. We have 3 extra volunteers helping getting covered this week. Thank you for your help. The church is beautiful. You got all those corners that he's been missing. James knows that I'm picking on him. I'm grateful for this. He's been doing that. Mark your calendars for St. Peter Claver Day Mass on coming up on September 12th at 9 o'clock here at Holy Redeemer. If you know anyone interested in becoming a Catholic, we'll be getting our RCIA classes September 13th. We will have classes in English and in Spanish. And if you know someone who's interested, please have them contact me. We will be getting confirmation class for adults in all 3 parishes. If you've not received the sacrament of confirmation, please call the parish office. Be sure to stay tuned for adult faith formation classes this fall, which will be led by Harold Williams here at Holy Redeemer, and all 3 parishes are welcome to join in that. And I think Anthony is supposed to be teaching something too. He promised me last year that he would.
I will be.
He's holding out on me. He did not only wear blue jeans to church today, but he's holding out on me when he's getting that information to me. Mark your calendars for Holy Redeemer's annual prayer breakfast, October the 2nd. Sister Odessa Stanford, SFCC from Houston, Texas, is scheduled to be the guest speaker. Tickets are available at the parish office. 2021 Fall Festival for St. Michael, Saturday, October 2nd, from 11 to 8 p.m. at the parish grounds. We are having a raffle. Our Lady of Petrohouse Barbecue Plate fundraiser and fall raffle is scheduled for October the 10th. Barbecue plates are 9, the raffle tickets are 2. We'll be doing curbside pickups. And we're continuing our annual campaign for the annual Archbishop's Appeal to start Archdiocesan Ministries. I ask you to prayerfully continue to pray for it, but also to give. Holy Redeemer has had 56 donors. We're at 17.1% participation rate. Holy Perpetual Help, 31 donors. We're at 8.9%. St. Michael's, you're at 34 donors at 7.8% participation rate. Thank you to all who continue to send their prayer intentions. Please know that I see them and I lift them up during my prayers. Coffee and donuts in the Mass and the hall today. Breakfast tacos at St. Michael's, while PH's hall still being renovated. And please continue to be safe during the coronavirus pandemic. Wear a mask, get vaccinated, and be safe. Be safe. You know, today I was going to use the example, but you know, Jesus said, nothing that comes from outside is impure. It's what comes from inside. So I have a confession to make. The donut that I'm going to eat or chew in the hall after Mass today is not sinful. It was waking up this morning and thinking, I'm going to eat 2 donuts in the hall after Mass. Now that, on the other hand, is a problem. So anyways, have a good day. We'll see you in the hall wherever you go. God bless.